House Cawdor owes much of its creation to the Cult of Redemption, a splinter sect of the Imperial Cult that heralds the doom of mankind. In this video, we're going to be painting Hawberk, a member of House Cawdor. Now, by following this paint guide, you'll be able to paint any member of House Cawdor, so when you're ready, let's get started. Before we begin painting, we'll need to undercoat the model, and as you can see here, I've used Mechanica Standard Grey. Now this is a great starting point for all the colours we'll be using in this paint guide. Now the first colour we'll be using is Steel Legion Drab, and we'll be doing this on the tattered brown cloth. So I'm going to get my medium layer brush, and I'll apply a little bit onto my palette, with a small touch of water, just probably like a tip of water really is all you need. This will just help it flow a bit better, and if we twist the brush like so, we get a nice point to it. And all we need to do is now start applying that to the model. Now there's a couple of sections we'll be leaving grey because we'll be painting those blue later on. But to start with, we'll just do all the brown cloth and then leave the other areas grey. And it might be worth doing a couple of coats of this as well. After applying a couple of coats of Steel Legion Drab, we're now going to move on to using some Norn Oil. And again, we're just going to use this over the Steel Legion Drab, and I'll be using a medium layer brush. So all we need to do is just get a little dollop on our brush like so, get it to a nice point, and then we'll start applying it on. You could do a couple of coats of this, but I think one should suffice. With the Norn Oil now dry, we're going to move on to the next step, which is to do some highlighting. And our first colour will be Steel Legion Drab. I'll be using a small layer brush, but we'll be doing a chunky highlight here, just so it's almost like a base for the final edge highlight. So I just add a little bit of water to the mix on the palette, get a nice point to my brush, and then we'll just start highlighting the model. So what we're doing here is we're just going to highlight all the raised areas like the folds on the cloth. And you want to do this all around the model. With the first highlight on the brown cloth done, we're now going to move on to the final highlight, and for this we'll be using Carrick Stone. So I'm going to continue using my small layer brush. I'm going to put some on the palette and a little bit of water just to help it flow a bit better. And also makes it easy to get a nice point on your brush as well. So I'll just twist that so I've got a nice point. And now what we're going to start doing is just picking out those raised areas, but we need these to be smaller than the last ones, just to help give a nice gradient. Just take your time and just make some real nice thin lines. And there we are, with that highlight done, the brown cloth is finished. So what we're going to do now is we're going to move on to painting the blue cloth as well as his face mask as well. For this we'll be starting with McCrank Blue. All we need to do is get a little bit onto the brush, apply it onto the palette as well. The usual, basically. Just get it to a nice point, and then we'll start applying it on. Now you've got to be very careful here, because obviously you've already painted some areas, so just be really super neat when you're going around other areas like the brown cloth you've just done here. And if you do make any mistakes, you can always paint back over it. Now that we've base coated the blue areas, we're now going to shade them, and for this we'll be using Norn Oil. Now we're continuing using my medium layer brush. What I would recommend is using your palette to obviously load up your brush, but try not to overload it, because obviously you've got other areas you've now highlighted, so you don't end up splodging on those areas. So just try and remove as much of that shade as you can before starting to apply it. And then all we need to do is just neatly run into those recesses. Always tidy up after using Macrag Blue again. Once the shade's thoroughly dry, we're now going to move on to doing some highlight. And the first colour we'll be using is Cawdor Blue. So I'm going to continue using my small layer brush. And as always, just get some on the palette like so, with a little touch of water, just to help get a nice point. And again, this is going to be a thicker highlight, so we're basically getting it prepped for the second highlight. So all we need to do, like we did on the brown cloth, is just do some nice thick broad highlights on all those raised areas. And with that done, we're now going to move on to our final highlight on the blue, which is to use Fenrisian Grey. Now I'll be using my small layer brush again. The idea is to just do a nice thin line, just give a nice gradient and help those colours pop out a bit. So once I've got it to a nice point, like so, we'll start highlighting all those edges. Again, just very similar to how we did the brown. There we are, with the blue highlighted. We're now going to move on to painting the metal areas. And for this, we'll be base coating with Lead Belcher. So I'm just going to get some paint on my brush. Just get it to a nice point, and then we'll start painting it. The areas we'll be painting, they're going to be the gun, the shaft of the weapon, as well as the blade on the actual end here as well. He's got his bionic leg, and on his cowl there's some rivets as well, so make sure you get those. With the metal area is now base coated, we're going to move on to applying some shades. And to start with, we'll be using Norn Oil. I'll be using a medium layer brush for this. This is just to help get some definition to all those silver areas. Just help those highlights pop out a bit when we start highlighting. So all we need to do is just run that all over these areas, like so. Get a bit more on my brush there. I am going over the bandages as well. There's some bandage areas here, but don't worry, we'll paint those later. Don't forget to do the rivets and his bionic leg as well. There we are, with the Norn oil now dry, we're going to move on to applying Agrax Earthshade. The idea behind this is to actually give it a scruffy, horrible, dirty feel to the metals. So we're just going to apply a little bit to the palette, a little touch of water, try to get a little bit more on there. We'll just start applying it over the metals. You can do a couple of coats for this, if you wish to make it even more dirty and rusty. That's up to you. With the Agrax Earthshade now dry, we're going to move on to making a nice rusty mix. And for this, we'll be using Scrag Brown and Lamy Medium. So using my medium layer brush, I'm just going to apply a couple of paintbrushes of Lamy Medium straight from the pot, and then a paintbrush of Scrag Brown. This will be nice and thin enough so it'll just sink into those recesses as well. What we'll do is then we'll start applying it to the metallic areas. Now again, we want to concentrate this in the recesses because that's where all the working parts are and where the rust is settled. If you want your rust to look a little bit less aged and a bit fresher, you can always substitute the Scrag Brown with something like Troll Slayer Orange instead. And that'll give it a really, really wet and fresh kind of looking rust. And again, you want to do this over all those metallic areas. And there we are with the rusty effect now dry. We're going to move on to doing some highlighting, and for this we'll be using Stormhost Silver. We don't need a lot, we're just picking out some of those small details like rivets and edges of weapons. So I'm just going to get a little bit of my brush, get it to a nice point like so. Then we'll just start picking out those raised areas. So you can use like the edge of your brush here, just on the blade. Actually, if you just sort of tap it a little bit, you get like a bit of a scattered effect. So it looks like it's burred and a bit damaged as well. So that helps with that rusty battered effect as well. With the metals now done, we're going to move on to painting the black areas. And for this, we'll be using Abaddon Black and Dawnstone. Now with the Abaddon Black, we're going to thin it down a little bit more than we normally do. Probably a paintbrush of black and a paintbrush of water. And what this will do is it will show some of that grey undercoat through. So it will give it a bit of a mid-tone highlight. So what I'm going to do is use my medium layer brush here. Just apply a little bit to the palette like so. And then like I said, a paintbrush of water. Actually, I'll add a little bit more because that's not quite watery enough. That's better. And then we'll just start applying that to the actual boots. And he's got a little bit of armour on the front of his cowl as well. So we'll apply it there too. With the black dry, we're now just going to pick out some raised details using Dawnstone. So this is things like the shoelaces, and just around like the edges of the boots as well. And don't forget, there's a little bit of armour on the cowl as well. So just pick out the edges of that. With the black now done, we're going to move on to painting the ropes, the bandages and the hair. And for this we'll be using Xandridus as a base coat. We'll then shade the ropes and the bandages with Agrax Earthshade. And for the hair we'll use Seraphim Seabird just to give it more of a blonde look. Then finally we'll highlight those areas using Screaming Skull. So using a small layer brush, I'm just going to get a little bit on my palette. A little touch of water as well, and then we'll start base coating all those areas. So we'll start with the rope around his neck first. Work onto the hair. And then this bandage is actually on the gun as well, and the shaft of the gun, as well as his leg. There we are, with the Xandridus base coat, we're now going to apply Agrax Earthshade just to the ropes and the bandage areas. We'll be coming to the hair in a moment or two. Now using Seraphim Seepier, we're just going to shade the hair. So give it more of a blonde look. With those areas now shaded and dry, we're going to start highlighting with Screaming Skull. For the bandage areas, I'd recommend just doing a bit of a highlight either side just to give it a suggestion of depth to it. And for the rope, all you need to do is just do like some little flicks just where the rope areas stick out. If you wanted to, you could even dry brush these areas if you're feeling confident enough. Do this on the hair as well. With the hair, the ropes and the bandage now done, we're going to move on to the final areas, which is the bone, the skin and the candles. Now for this, we'll be using Rakar Flesh. We'll be shading the candles and the bone with Seraphim Sepia. We'll use Rykon Flesh Shade for the skin. We'll probably do two coats of this, and we'll highlight up with Pallid Witch Flesh. So starting with that Rakar Flesh, I'm just going to apply a little bit to my palette, like so, and a little touch of water as well. I'm using a small layer brush for this as well for better control, because these are like the last few details now. So I want to make sure we don't splodge on any of the colours. So we'll start with the hand and the bone itself. In fact, you can just paint this all in one go, because actually it's all going to be the same base coat. With the Rakar Flesh now based, we're going to apply Seraphim Sepia to the bone and the candle. One coat should do. Once the Seraphim Sepia is dry, we're going to apply Rykon Flesh Shade to the skin. I'm going to do two coats of this, so when the first one's dry, just apply the second. With that shade now dry, we're going to start highlighting with padded witch flesh on all the details. So whether that's on the knuckles of the hand, areas around the bone, or on the drips that's on the candle. You want to get a nice fine point to your brush when you're doing this as well. With the model based, he's now ready to bring zealous retribution to his rivals in the Underhive. Now there are a couple of things to remember when painting this model. Firstly, when doing any highlighting, try and keep your brush to a nice point, especially around those fine details. Secondly, when doing any shading, just be very careful around those other painted details and try to avoid pooling in the recesses. I hope you've enjoyed this video. I hope you enjoy painting your own house Cawdor Gangers, and we'll see you again soon. Bye bye.